Ni hao. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor for me to be able to play this recital in this incredibly beautiful hall. As you know, this is the first opera house and concert hall built in China.
女士们、先生们，大家晚上好。那么对于我来说是非常大的荣幸，能够在这么漂亮的音乐厅里面进行音乐会。那么可能大家也知道，这个音乐厅是在中国的第一家既是歌剧院也是音乐厅的场所。
It is also a great pleasure to be able to play on this beautiful new Bechstein Concert Grand, which has been constructed recently.
那么当然也是一个非常高兴的机会，能够使用这一台全新的C. Bechstein 贝希斯坦钢琴举办这场音乐会。这个钢琴刚刚造好的。
So I shall start the first part of this concert by improvising. As you know, this tradition has been lost in our days among us, the so-called classical pianists.
那么这个音乐会首先呢，由一首即兴演奏的作品作为开始。那么可能大家也了解，那么即兴演奏呢，在我们他将演奏的这些曲子，那么在我们现在这个时候呢，被称作古典音乐。
Only jazz pianists and organ players improvise today, unfortunately, and I'm trying to bring back into light the tradition of improvisation.
那么当今呢，只有爵士还有现代的钢琴演奏家还在进行即兴的演奏。所以他希望通过这一次的演出呢，把这样子的传统的即兴演奏的方式呢，再带回给大家。
Chopin, Liszt, before them, Mozart, Beethoven, Bach were great improvisers.
那么肖邦、李斯特，那么甚至比他们更早的莫扎特、巴赫、贝多芬，那么他们呢都是非常伟大的即兴演奏者。
Therefore, I shall improvise on various themes which will pass into my head, and I should not forget that we are also in an opera house, so I should include also some opera themes.
那么他演奏的内容呢，就是这个瞬间经过他脑子里想到的内容。那么当然，他也会时刻的想着这个音乐厅，同时也是歌剧厅，所以他会有一些新的想法在这个里面。
谢谢。
谢谢。
Thank you.
Yes, yes, thank you very much. I guess now we have to go into some serious stuff.
那我们，我想接下来我们来一些严肃的事情。
So I'm going to play what I believe is the greatest piano masterpiece of Franz Schubert, his last sonata, which is in four movements.
那么接下来我要演奏的是我认为是舒伯特最伟大的一个钢琴奏鸣曲作品，他的最后一首奏鸣曲。那么一共有四个乐章。
As you know, Schubert died when he was only 31. And in the last year of his life, in 1828, he wrote so many of his greatest masterpieces.
那么大家可能知道，当舒伯特去世的那一年，他仅有31岁。那么他在去世的最后一年的时间里面，写了非常多的、非常伟大的作品。
During the composition of this sonata in B flat major, D960.He probably was already feeling the end of his life, which was going to come very soon.
那么当他在创作这一首作品的时候，他有可能已经意识到了他可能他的生命即将结束，或者在非常快的时间内即将结束。
In some parts, Schubert is telling us life is too hard, I'm giving up. But in other parts,This is the strange thing. He's giving us a lesson of courage.
那么在一部分的乐曲中呢，你可以感受到舒伯特觉得生活太艰苦了。那么我已经这个受不了了。但是非常奇怪的是，在另外一部分中，他又鼓励大家对于这种生存的这种希望。
The second movement is such a masterpiece. I mean, it's from another world.And when the main theme of the beginning comes back, the left hand, I always think of a quartet, is like playing like a double bass, reminding Beethoven rhythmically the destiny, the fatality, which, from which one cannot escape.
那么第二乐章的部分，这个简直是一个非常可以说是一个宏伟的巨作。那么它在很多的地方，那么包括在左手的这个低音的部分，那么很有的地方让他想起了这个贝多芬的一些作品的内容。
The third movement is a scherzo, and for me at least, it represents an angel of death which is coming to take us to the other side.
那么当然还有一部分呢，是可以让你感觉到好像有一个死亡的天使正在向他走近，那么他好像要带着他去往另外一个世界。
And the last movement, Allegro moderato, is finally smiling, but the smile has always a tear.
那么最后一个乐章，最后第四乐章呢，那么这个里面是好像一直充满了微笑，但是这个微笑呢，永远是带着眼泪的微笑。
And it always reminds me the fact that Mozart composed his famous 23rd piano concerto in A major during March, and although it has some happiness into it, it is always covered by a veil, a little bit like the sun in March.Which is covered sometimes by clouds.
那么当然这一部分呢，有一部分让他想起了莫扎特的这个一些风格，当然也想起了这个好像三月里面的一个阳光，那么永远呢是伴随着一些美丽的这种白云的。
And the end of this fourth movement, suddenly, you know, after this passage saying to us, "Bye bye, I'm going to leave," you know.Suddenly it stops, and there is a coda, an ending, very short, full of energy and triumph, as if Schubert was saying to us,
那么这个最后
never get despaired,
那么最后的这一部分的乐句呢，那么给大家的感觉是它好像充满了能量，那么又充满了这样子的希望。
Because the spirit will win on the matter, and it's like, okay, the body dies, but it's the triumph of the eternity of the soul of the spirit, which finds finally its eternity.
那么这个就好像是一种我们的灵魂，那么虽然这个已经接近死亡，但是灵魂已经超越了，那么可以他的灵魂，他的精神，那么可以一直延续，这是一种凯旋，好像是一种胜利。
Thank you.
Thank you.
So now I'm going to play for you a rarity of Jean-Baptiste Leuillet.
那么接下来呢，我们我将为您各位演奏的是约翰劳莱特，来自伦敦的约翰劳莱特的作品。
He was born in 1680.
他出生于1680年。
In the city of Ghent, which is today Belgium.
那么他在一个叫做 Ghent 的城市，那么现在呢，如今是属于比利时的地方。
Then he established in London, and he changed his name into John Leuillet from London.
那么然后呢，他在定居在了伦敦，然后他就把他的名字呢改变为来自伦敦的约翰劳莱特。
Because he had a cousin who was also born in Ghent.And who had the same first name and same family name, Jean-Baptiste Leuillet.
那么因为呢是他有一个表兄，那么他呢跟他有完全一样的名字，所以呢他把这个名字给改了。
The cousin was also a famous composer who lived in France.
那么这个表兄呢是也是一个非常有名的作曲家，那么生活在法国。
And the one of London, which I'm going to play, had also a brother called Jacques Leuillet, and he was also a composer.
那么，这个来自伦敦的这位约翰呢，他有一位兄弟，那么他也是一个著名的作曲家，那么他名字叫杰克劳莱特。
And right after, I will play a beautiful transcription on the same piece of Leuillet.A beautiful transcription made by Leopold Godowsky, who, as you know, was a great pianist, and he wrote many pieces for piano and transcriptions, who lived in the beginning of the 20th century.
那么在这个曲子随后呢，他将演奏一首由奥利波特·戈多夫斯基那么的作品。那么这个作品呢，同样是改编自劳莱特的这一首库朗特舞曲。那么大家可能知道这个戈多夫斯基呢，那么也是20世纪的一个非常有名的音乐家。
Now I'm going to play four pieces connected with Chopin.
那么接下来我将演奏四首作品，那么都和肖邦有联系。
The first piece is a mazurka.
第一首呢是一首马祖卡。
Written by a very, very close friend of Chopin, Julian Fontana.
那么是由肖邦的一个非常好朋友写的，他的名字叫做儒勒·丰塔纳。
One always read about him in books and booklets of CDs. He was one of these people who really helped Chopin to get his music published.
那么如果看到一个 CD 的这个小册子的时候呢，您会发现他是这个将肖邦的作品发表的这位。
But guess what? He was a very good composer.
那么你们猜，其实他本人也是一个非常好的作曲家。
He was also from Poland.
那么他也来自波兰。
So I shall play a mazurka by Fontana and then a mazurka by Chopin.
那么，所以接下来要演奏一首由丰塔纳做的马祖卡，随后呢是一首肖邦做的马祖卡。
And as you know, the problem of the mazurka interpretation is that it must not be confused with the three beats of the waltz. The problem of the mazurka interpretation is that it should not be confused, because mazurka is in three beats, one, two, three. But it's not the same thing like the three beats of the waltz.
那么这个马祖卡的一个在演绎的时候的一个问题呢，就是这个马祖卡虽然也是三拍的这个曲子，但是呢它的这个三拍和圆舞曲的三拍是不一样的。
Then I shall play a very, very short piece by Schumann called Chopin.
那接下来随后第三首呢，将演奏一首非常小的这个作品，是由舒曼做的这个作品，名字叫做肖邦。
Which is coming from his famous Carnaval.
那么这个曲子呢，是选自他著名的狂欢节。
Schumann was a big fan of Chopin, but Chopin was not a big fan of Schumann.
舒曼呢是肖邦的一个很大的一个粉丝，但是肖邦不是舒曼的粉丝。
And then the fourth piece of these little Chopin group pieces, or connected with Chopin, is a piece I composed recently called "Merci, Monsieur Chopin." Thank you, Mr. Chopin. 谢谢 Chopin.
那么第四首呢，在这个一组的肖邦有联系的作品当中呢，第四首曲子的是由他在近期创作的，由卡萨利斯先生创作的，那么名字叫做《感谢肖邦先生》。
Why? Because I believe that it helps in order to understand the spirit of a composer. It helps when you try to write a piece in the style of that composer.
那么为什么他要这样做呢？他相信，就是当你需要学习一个作曲家的作品的时候，那么可能更好的方式，或者是更容易理解的方式，是试着以作曲家创作的方式自己去创作一个作品。
I also did it with Mozart, Rachmaninoff, Schumann, and Chopin.
当然，他也用这样子的方法创造了很多的类似莫扎特、肖邦、舒曼这样子的作品。
谢谢，
谢谢。Thank you.
No, I have to tell them, yes, okay. So I'm going to finish this program with a paraphrase on a Strauss waltz. I'm saying this for the foreigners because the program is only in Chinese, I think, yes?
那么接下来要演奏的这个作品呢，是在一个施特劳斯的作品上进行的改编。
It's the famous waltz Wiener Blut, and it's arranged, paraphrased on the piano by Edward Schütt.
那么这个作品呢，改编的是由爱德华·徐特来进行的改编。
Edward Schütt was born in St. Petersburg in the 19th century.
那么他出生于19世纪。
And then I will finish with my solo transcription of Liszt Concerto No. 2.
那最后呢是演奏由他自己改编的李斯特的第二钢琴协奏曲。
谢谢。Thank you.
So I shall play now the adagio from the oboe concerto of Alessandro Marcello, arranged for keyboard by Johann Sebastian Bach. Adagio from concerto of Alessandro Marcello, they understand.
Okay.
Arranged for keyboard, for cembalo or piano by Bach.
Okay. 一个由巴哈改编的一个协奏曲的作品。